Last year, I paid a visit to my old neighbor, the Pokemon Professor, to purchase a really old vintage Pokemon card collection. Well, at Christmas, he actually messaged me and said he's found some more cards. He was in the garage, he was dusting off some old cobwebs, and there it lay. More cards and more nostalgia just sat there. However, unfortunately, a few days before Christmas last year, the UK went into another lockdown and I was unable to go and see this collection. Recently though, I took a trip to my parents with my brother and family, and I ended up going around and finding the remains of this collection. And in this video, I'm gonna show you everything that we picked up in detail. So sit back, relax, and enjoy. Yo, what's up guys? Welcome back to the channel. Hopefully you're all doing good. As you can tell, London right now is getting to that part of the year where it's very humid, it's very hot, especially when you're in an apartment building. So you're gonna start seeing me a little bit flustered and a little bit sweaty on the channel from here on out until winter again, I guess. But that's fine, because as you guys can see down below, I have some absolute fire to show you guys today. We have cards in 20-year-old, who remembers these? I remember these. They're so good. And look, you can literally see how old these cards are and these boxes are, because the actual rubber bands are not elastic anymore. They just snap off. So it's actually incredible. And when I was going through these originally, the bands were around the entire box, so you could tell these just weren't touched. So how do we want to do this? Should we go through some, let's do the hollows first. Most people will leave the hollows till the end and try and, like, you know, leave the best till last. But I'm just going to show you guys straight up. You guys came here to see content, I'm going to show you content. So we got some hollows here. Let's go through those first and we'll go through the commons. They are great commons, by the way. There's some really old vintage stuff in here. Well, obviously it's all vintage. Actually, you know what? Let's go through the binder first. This does have actually hollows in it, so I'm not capping there. As you can see, we have some of the Wizards of the Coast promo cards, and you can tell. So for those who don't know who the Pokemon Professor is, he is a guy who is a neighbor of mine and my brothers and my family growing up. He used to run the weekly Pokemon club in the town, in the community. Did a great service for all the kids at school, etc. And that's why you can see prices on these cards, because he would sell these at the club. I can't imagine what cards he's sold over the years, but these are what didn't sell, so we're thankful for that now. As you can see, we've got the Eevee Black Star promo, the Mew that always grades a 9. I swear you never see these in 10s. Well, you do obviously, but they're very rare. And as you can tell, this wouldn't get a 10, but it's still great regardless. You guys know as well, in recent videos, I've been saying that I'm not too keen or I don't care about the quality anymore. Like, don't get me wrong, I love gem mint 10s, I love mint 9s, etc. But I want the cards more than I want the actual grades. I do enjoy slabbing my cards, don't get me wrong, and I enjoy grading them. I just don't feel like the grade is everything, you know? So here we go, we got some more Japanese cards right here. We got a Pruly Seedra right there. We have some Southern Islands cards. And here we go, I love this artwork. This Poliwrath is so, so good. I just love that style. And here we go, here we have some Japanese hollow. I love the Japanese hollows as well. They're so clean, always so nice. We got Starmie up there. Loved that card as a kid. Pidgeot again. We've seen two of those now. The Kingdra as well. Mr. Hero Arita artwork. The Vaporeon cards. Absolutely sublime. And look at these. A pound each, guys. I didn't pay a pound, obviously, for these, but they're actually fantastic. And yeah, there we go. So that's that binder. Nice little collection of some Japanese hollows. So here we go. Here are some of the hollows that were in this collection that I, you know, kind of found within the rest of the boxes. Let's split some up here real quick. So first of all, we have some secret rares from some of the EX Nintendo sets. So we've got the Pikachu there. We got the, I'm not sure why the Espeon's there. Rockets, Raikou EX, love that card. We've got the Absol right here. Charmeleon, Azumarill. Now these are really great cards, guys. Kranidos, Farfetch'd, very nice. Charmeleon again from Team Rocket Returns. Mew right there. Love this card. We can see some scratches there, but I believe that might be the case. Yeah, it's the case. The holo, oh, look at that holo. It's just fantastic. Really, really nice. Again, it's not perfect condition, but it's not bad either. Good enough for me. So we've got the Mew, we've got the Charmander from Fire Red Leaf Green, Groudon. Sucks. I'm just kidding. I like Groudon, guys. I just tease Connor, but I like Groudon. A Dragonair reverse from Expedition. We've got a Jinx reverse from Expedition. We've got a Beedrill reverse, reverse Ray actually there, which I need to get in sleeves. Dark Blastoise. These are just non-hollows, but it's just in that pile. There we go. Let's get that Beedrill in a case, or in a sleeve, sorry, should I say. Carrying on, we have some Watsy hollows. Now, these are really bent, as you can see right here, so I don't know if I'll be able to... they're usually okay if you can kind of get them to not bend. If they crease, it's a problem, but I'm not sure these are at that stage yet. I think they might be salvageable. I'm not too sure. We've got a Lieutenant Surge's Fever right there. And other than the bend, they actually are quite clean. Obviously, they've been sat in boxes for many years in the garage, so they are going to see some damage here and there. And as you can see, the bend really is quite severe. Got Misty Seedra, got two of those. Got Rockets Moltres, Rockets Trap, Rockets Trap again. We've got Misty's Gyarados. You can always tell when a card's playable back then, because this was $3.90 compared to the Japanese hollows. And I know the Japanese, and back then, Japanese were definitely not as sought after as it is now, but even still, you know. Trainer cards are useful. We've got the Misty's Gyarados there as well. Looking clean. That's a clean card. We got some more here. We got Koga, Misty's Golduck. Love this card. Love the artwork. First edition, very hard to get in a 10, as you saw the other day, but still fantastic. We got Brock's Ninetales. First edition Brock's Ninetales. Another Brock's Ninetales. Another Koga. Heracross. First edition Heracross from Neo Genesis. Another really hard card to get in a 10. This won't get it, obviously, though, but still another Heracross there. Muk. We got Jumpluff from Neo Gen. Kingdra from Neo Gen, non-first edition. And then we actually had some base set as well, which is really, really cool. You got the Alakazam with the Blastoise. Come on. We do have the Charizard as well. But as you can see, it does have this mark right here. Well, you definitely can see the actual dot, but what you can't see is that's actually, it's actually teared the front of the card. So the holo foil is showing, if that makes any sense. Not the best on the back either, but honestly, for a Charizard, still pretty good. We have a Gyarados too. And then we have the Venusaur, the chunky Venusaur as well from base set. So really happy with these. I don't think I'll send these to PSA though, because their times are just, well, they're closed right now, but their times are just getting horrific, as you saw with my express returns of the day. But they're in my collection, probably gonna make some binder sets, and I'm really happy to have them for sure. All right, let's get into one of the boxes now with the old tape that just comes apart. There we go. It's so funny. All right, let's see what we have in this one right here. There's always a card that gets stuck in the bottom, or a couple of cards. All right, but let's see. Now, not all of these are sleeved. It looks like these are Neo Genesis commons and uncommons. So I actually got quite a few of these in the original purchase, but there's some more here, as you can see. Not all of them are sleeved, so I need to go back and sleeve these, but they are mint condition, or at least some are mint condition, you know? Got the Cyndaquil there. See, I need to go through sleeve all these. Look at, like, you've got a random sleeve there with no card in it. So let's fix some of these real quick. Let's put a Hoot Hoot in the sleeve. Oh, did anyone see that? Oh, it wasn't focused. Oh, that was a 20-year-old sleeve that was stuck shut. I had to pop that open. It's so cool, man. These have just been untouched for so long. More cards, as you can see. I'm just going to quickly skip through these. Like, they are just duplicates after duplicate, but they are still really cool. In good nick as well. So yeah, oh, I got the Pikachu there as well. Oh, that needs a sleeve. We need to sleeve this boy up. Relatively clean as well. Obviously, you can see a big nick there, but yeah, it's still nice. So it looks like this box right here. Oh, shout out to Zerka. Shout out to Josh Zerka right here. Slowpokes for days. Yeah, it looks like this is Neo Genesis first edition, which is a continuation of what I actually bought in the original purchase. These must have just been left to one side. So here it looks like we have Neo Discovery. We've got some Teddy Ursa here. Tyrogue. Very nice. Yeah, so when I bought the collection, he had some holos from Neo Destiny. No. Some holos from, actually a few Neo Destiny, but not no Shinings. I think mainly it was Discovery and Revelation. So, but there were no commons from Revelation or Discovery. So I guess this is where they were, in a separate box in the garage. So it's nice to actually find these and, you know, get the actual commons that the original purchase didn't contain. Got some more here as well. Scyther, love that card. Love the illustration. So, so nice. Unknown for days, actually. Then we have, oh, we have some Eevee. Very, very nice. Look at that. How many Eevee we have? Nice. Eevee Heroes just came out, the Japanese set. So we have to show some respect to Eevee here. We've got some more Eevee. We've got Igglybuff here too. Kakuna. Metapod, aka Matata. Almost our first edition. So we've got some unlimited, some first edition. We've got some trainers here. Corsola. Caterpie. Dunsparce. And then some more. So yeah, this looks like the Neo Discovery common slash uncommon box. We've got Mareep there as well. I wonder if we have any like rares or any more uncommons here. I think we've actually seen the uncommons from these. Now we're getting into the commons. Now this one must be, yes, this is the Revelation box now. So as you can see, these are definitely continuations of the first purchase that I made. Oh, I love that Starmie card. Oh, I love it so much. Right, we've got Apom, Chinchou, Farfetch'd. These are first edition as well. Geodude, love that artwork. Very, very nice. We've got Goldeen, Paris holding the mushroom. What are you doing with that mushroom, Paris? Stay safe. Quagsire, Geodude again, Quillfish. And again, you guys can see they're just duplicates. Oh, Slugma balls, let's go. Leave a like on this video. Go and comment. Make sure you subscribe to the channel. Leave a like on the video and comment down below, Slugma balls, and I'll give away this card right here to one of you guys. No matter where you are in the world, anywhere, we'll get this card delivered to you. Yeah, so leave a like, subscribe to the channel, and comment down below, Slug My Balls, and I'll pick one of you guys to win. And it looks pretty clean, I got to admit. It looks pretty clean. All right, I'm putting that to one side for you guys. Let's go. Oh, it's a Star You, sorry. It's not Star Me, it's Star You. It's still a great card, though. I just love it so much. Mr. Hero Arita, I believe, yep, with the illustration. And here we go. Some more here. We've got Zubat, Oldrod. We got Flaffy. We have Golbat. Oh, that's a sick card. Graveler, Jinx. Very, very nice. Kamiya artwork, yep. So we've got some uncommons here, which is really nice to see. We've got Octillery as well. Some more uncommons, Seeking, and then some more unknown and some more trainers. This might be the final box. We have that box right there, and then we have one right here, but I believe, let's just quickly check. I believe this is all energy. Yeah, this is just all energy cards, which is still really cool. I can make some vintage decks. But yeah, we don't have to go into the depths of the energy one. Let's see what we have here. Oh, we got Blaine's Charmander. Okay, let's see what we have here. All right, so this must be just a random. Oh, we got Jungle. Primeape. Let's go. We've got Slowpoke, Seedra from Fossil. Okay, yeah, these are a little bit more beat up than the rest, as you can see.
There's also another pile in there, but there's more cards in there? Oh, hold on, hold on. There's more cards in the box.
Yes, these must be like a random... Yeah, this is like a random box of everything. We've got Arcanine there, Talsimon, oh, Pidgeot, Snorlax. These are non-hollows, but they're still really, really cool. Very, very nice. Lapras there as well. Come on. Then it looks like some Gym Heroes, Commons. I'd imagine some Challenge as well. Oh, all Heroes for now. Yes, there's some more leftover Gym Heroes, Unlimited. Commons and uncommons. No challenge? Yeah, no challenge. Okay, we do have some more. I found more boxes in the actual big box itself. And these look like gym challenge. There we go. Okay, so now we've got the gym challenge commons. Let's flick through these real quick. I'm sure you guys get the gist. Oh, Ekans, stay back as my guy. Said it first, you owe me a Coke. I don't know. So sick. Just the nostalgia. I'm really excited to put some binder sets together. As you guys know, Project Binder is in full swing. Even though you might not see it, it is in full swing behind the scenes. I'll update you guys with progress as we go. Blaine Charmeleon. Woo! Rapidash. Nice, this is so cool to look at. It looks like we do have some more holos in this batch right here. However, as you can see, this is the condition of them, which is why they're not in the main pile I showed you earlier. Like, look at this Golbat. Ooh, baby, seen better days. We got Kangaskhan, Machamp, first edition, unlimited, Poliwrath, Hitmonchan, another Machamp, and another Magneton. As you guys can see there, these are just, yeah, these are straight ones. And then in the final box, it looks like we have some unsleeved. Actually, I think these are rares, you know. Oh, okay, we had like a few rares. A small amount of rares. Then we have trainers and we have some energy from the E-series. Very, very nice. Some first edition again. As you can see, that Magmi though is completely bent. So this might be just like poor quality cards they put to one side and they thought didn't deserve a sleeve. All right, so I think they were the last of the bunch. Thank you guys for sticking with me in this video. Don't forget to leave a comment saying slug my balls, like the video, subscribe, and I'll deliver that card to one of you guys, or I'll post it to one of you guys, or ship it to you if you live overseas. But yeah, thank you guys for watching another collection video, and shout out to the Pokemon Professor once more for allowing me to pick these cards up from you. If you keep finding cards, keep letting me know. But yeah, that's it from me today, guys. Thank you so much for the support. As always, it's been great. I'll see you guys tomorrow for some more Pokemon content. For now though, take care and peace out.